Hi, welcome you all. I'm Dr. Rajni. I'm a dentist by education and a certified clinical nutritionist. I'm very passionate about health and nutrition. So this passion has driven me to share my knowledge with you all today. This is my first webinar and the topic is role of nutrition in women's life. And I'll talk about bone health. So what you all know, I just want to understand from each one of you, like what you know about nutrition. Hi, Dr. Sarna, welcome.
Hi, Rajni. Okay, what is nutrition is, don't have much knowledge about it, but balanced meal maybe.
So what are we going to learn today from this webinar? I'll just start with four pillars of health. What are the basic four pillars of health that balance our health? And followed by nutrition, I'll just explain about a few basics for your understanding and how the nutritional needs are different for women and what are the common health issues that women generally face at different stages of her life, and you'll have a better understanding on bone health, and finally the tips to live to the fullest. So what are you waiting for? So what are the four basic pillars of health? Very clear from this slide? You're able to see the slide? So what are the four basic pillars of health? Nutrition, exercise, relaxation, and sleep. Today I'll be talking about nutrition more, a little bit about exercise, relaxation, and sleep, because it is really tough to cover entire the topic at one go. Hope we understand that. And all these pillars are equally important to keep your mind and body healthy. So what is nutrition? Nutrition is the food we take and how we use that to perform various functions in the body, how we utilize it in the body. So what are nutrients? So nutrients are the substances which we get from food that helps to nourish our body. So they help to perform various functions in the body. Right? So there are variety of nutrients, as you all know. So anyone knows what are the nutrients?
Yes.
Lahari, can you tell me?
Carbohydrates, protein, fat, vitamins, minerals.
Water?
And water.
Very good. Anything missing?
Carbohydrates.
Yes, carbohydrates, proteins, fats. These are the major food groups. They are called as macronutrients. And the micronutrients are vitamins, minerals, even the phytochemicals that we get, like antioxidants from plants. Even water is the most important thing to carry these nutrients as a vehicle. So what is the purpose of carbohydrates? So carbohydrates, every nutrient has its own role in the body and they perform multiple functions in the body as well. So carbohydrates' major purpose is they are energy-giving food. If you don't eat carbohydrates, you don't get energy that quickly. Like how you, when you rely on only proteins, you know how you'll become cranky, stressed, angry, right? Have you all experienced that before? Right. And proteins helps to build the tissues. I don't want to tell this, I want to know from you. So why do you take proteins? Everybody knows that proteins has to be taken for good health or whatever. So for what purpose you consider?
Muscle strength.
Huh?
For good muscle strength.
Yes, exactly. I expected this. Anything else?
For the tissue repair.
Yes, good. Next.
And for
synthesis of antibodies.
Yes. So that means it is not just for muscle health. Everybody says eat protein, you'll get good muscle. Yes, that is true. Other than that, there are many other functions the proteins have. It helps in repair of the tissues. So it helps in the formation of tissues. They are the building blocks of the tissues. So proteins helps in repair. So every time your body cells gets destroyed, gets created, reformed, regenerated periodically. Right. So, have you ever been to a beautician? Have you ever heard beauticians telling you come for facial once in a month like that? Why is it so only once in a month?
That's something that every beautician will tell very
You know, it has a, seriously, they are right, and it has a scientific reason also. I just want to tell about the repair actually. You know,
yeah.
The skin cells gets regenerated every month, every 1 month. So she asked you to come and visit her for facial so that she will remove that dead layer, right? Fats are the major storage form of energy. So they act as fuel when needed, right? So there are many uses of fats, especially those who are residing in extreme cold weather, they know very well. It acts as an insulator, protects from extreme cold. That's why in North India, they ask us to eat a lot of peanut laddu, til laddu. Isn't it?
Yes, 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 ma'am.
Yes. So we don't eat such that type of til laddu, sesame laddu or peanut on everyday basis in South India. So all diet is confined to the climate and temperature where we stay, right? So, and fats are also very important in the manufacturing various and preparing various hormones in the body. These fats are also used to protect cell membranes. The cells, tissues are made by proteins and the structure membranes are maintained by the fats. Fats play a major role in protecting the brain cells, brain cell membranes and all. So those who doesn't take fats in their diet properly, they'll have problems in the later life like Alzheimer's disease, you know, frequent memory loss. So most of the essential fatty acids are manufactured, I should say, are prepared in the body by itself, and certain things we need to procure from diet, especially omega-6 fatty acids and omega-3. And it's a huge topic about cooking oils, which I'll be covering later in my webinars or YouTube. So make sure you have a diet cooking oils that are rich in monounsaturated fatty acids, less in polyunsaturated and very less in saturated fatty acids, whatever may be the source of the oil. A small tip from my side. So coming to vitamins, minerals. So, okay, anyone can speak out. What are the vitamins we generally know? Like, what all you know? Pandemic?
So
yeah.
A,
got, yeah.
B, C,
vitamin
D.
A. E.
Vitamin E.
Potassium.
Magnesium is mineral. Good. Very good.
Vitamin B12,
yes. So there are fat soluble vitamins and water soluble vitamins. Fat soluble vitamins are A, D, E, K. PC are water soluble vitamins. So fats are very essential. If you are dividing fat in your diet, these vitamins are not absorbed into the body only. I am putting on weight, I don't want to touch any fat, I want fat-free diet, no weight will not work. Dheere, muscle, you will lose the memory. You will not have any fat-soluble vitamins, you will not have vitamin E as an antioxidant. So with everything, will be lack of all these vitamins. And the effect of these lack of vitamins will be seen later. And minerals. So can you list me minerals if you know?
Wait.
Someone told me potassium.
Potassium, magnesium, phosphorus,
wow,
selenium.
Wow.
I don't know what.
Wow, interesting. yes. The most important vitamin for, sorry, mineral for women. Can you tell me?
Calcium.
Wow. Very good. So, calcium. Yes. That decides our bone health. Hai na?
Yeah.
Yes. So there are many minerals, calcium, phosphorus, potassium, sodium, magnesium, manganese. All these minerals are used in minimum quantities in the body. They are used for different purposes like cellular functions. Inside every cell, the cell has multiple organelles that perform various functions in the body. So every function to go in a balance, it needs all the nutrients in balanced amounts. Do you know that human body is made up of 73 trillions of cells? Every cell has its own function. And it needs nutrients on an everyday basis. It gets nutrients from blood. It doesn't stop, even though we sleep, it doesn't stop. So when anything is missing from your diet on long run, it will show its effect, pakka. That is for sure. Especially, I think by this pandemic, everybody must have understood the importance of vitamin D.
100%.
So, initially we used to think vitamin D is for bone health, but the pandemic has taught us it is very important for immunity as well. So, what does it mean? No single role for each vitamin. It has multiple roles for every nutrient. So don't consider, I don't want to take fat because I will put on weight. No, you must have understood by this time it has multiple roles in the body. I need to retain my memory. I need to protect myself from cold. So many things. So what are phytochemicals from plants? Good, good. Have you ever heard anyone telling you, have a rainbow diet?
Rainbow diet?
Yeah.
Hello.
Rainbow has 7 colors, so have a colorful diet. That means try to implement in your diet different colored fruits and vegetables. Why they are specific? Because every color has its own phytochemical antioxidant. All blue colored fruits and vegetables are rich in anthocyanins. Orange color, carrot, tomatoes, they are rich in carotenes. Green color, rich in chlorophyll. You must have seen many ads have green smoothies in the morning. So it's rich in chlorophyll. It's phytochemical that acts as an antioxidant. There are few vitamins and minerals also that act as antioxidants. I'll tell you what is antioxidant. So vitamin E, selenium, for example, they act as antioxidants. Only that we know before. But now there are so many phytochemicals. Are we really having the rainbow diet every time?
Not always.
Not always. But we need to. But we should switch to local seasonal foods. Instead of buying
exotic
ones. Yeah. So because exotic or stored for longer time, it loses nutrients after storage. Okay. So antioxidants. I'm talking about antioxidants. What is the role of opposite oxidation? So as I told you earlier, cell, each and every cell performs certain functions internally. So when anything work is done, certain waste is also released. That is called metabolic waste. Cellular metabolism. After cellular metabolism, it releases certain metabolic waste. Even that has to be removed from cells periodically, timely. That is carried away through blood, then excreted out through excretory organs. So these metabolic waste are nothing but the free radicals. They are called as free radicals that are generated after cellular metabolism. Suppose if these free radicals are not removed timely, they cause damage to the cells. So anything, even if we get constipation for a long time, how will be the state of our health? Just imagine. Can we eat properly? Mood also will get upset. So these antioxidants, once we eat through fruits and vegetables, when they circulate through blood, they pull out these free radicals at least from each and every cell. So they help in cleansing your body free of free radicals. Antioxidants is an interesting topic which we all should know. Everybody knows something or the other, 1%, 2%, 3% about all these nutrients which I spoke about, carbohydrates, proteins, fats, minerals. This is a basic which everybody knows. But you all should know about this free radical damage inside the cells. So the free radical damage not only due to cellular metabolism, there are many factors that cause free radical damage of the cells. If the cells get damaged, the entire organ gets damaged, the entire tissue gets damaged. Then the organ also, yeah, So suppose if that damage occurs in any particular part of the body, it will show its effects later. So free radical damage is also caused due to various factors like pollution, and anything that causes damage to the body comes under anti-nutrients. They can be called as anti-nutrients, which are harmful for the body. Excessive alcohol, excessive smoking, food containing pesticides, that's why people are going for organic nowadays. Charcoal. Have you seen charcoal foods nowadays? Charcoal burger.
Because of its black. I think just regular black color. That's
black. Okay.
Charcoal cakes.
Charcoal cakes. Okay. I'll tell about
Bangalore, yeah.
Yeah. You know what is the nature of the charcoal? It absorbs everything with it. It absorbs everything. So it will not let absorb any nutrient in the body. That is the work of charcoal. So better avoid charcoal foods. Even burnt foods also have high charcoal. Heavily barbecued foods also have charcoal.
So Rajni, one doubt here. So that's the reason they use charcoal preparations for poisoning cases and all.
Yes, exactly. I was about to tell that. Yes, exactly. I still wonder how their government has accepted to use in burgers and other food items. I still wonder. We have seen in cosmetics, that's okay. But not in the food. I don't think it's advisable in the foods. And coming to tap water. Certain areas, they have arsenic, nitrates, aluminium in a heavy content in tap waters, which are very dangerous and poisoning to the body. And air pollution, which we cannot avoid, but we can prepare our body to fight against those free radicals again. Okay, food containing artificial colors and even preservatives. Okay, processed foods. What are processed foods? You all know. Pizza, burger.
High amount of salt, high.
Perfect. Sugar. High amount of fat.
Sugars.
Yes, fat is not bad, but the type of fat they are using is hydrogenated.
Yeah, good and bad fat.
Yes, the worst fat is hydrogenated fat. So make sure next time whatever you buy in the market, you read the nutritional information backside so that it should not have trans fats or hydrogenated fat on it. Whatever you eat, whatever you put inside, make sure it will not have hydrogenated fat. All the chocolates are made up of hydrogenated fat, so minimize the intake. Women have unique nutritional needs. Yes, even more than men. This is because of hormonal difference. And they're always multitasking, taking care of the family, work life, multiple things, and they first fulfill the family needs than theirs. Isn't it? Will you all agree with me?
Yeah, always.
All lovely mothers.
And in doing so, we ignore ourselves.
Yes, true. We ignore ourselves. Yes, true. If the woman is not well in the family, how it is going to impact their kids' life and entire family? So, what my mom told me, one thing. She said, Rajni, I was giving importance to the family always. And I even forgot about myself, whether I'm hungry or not, whether should I feed myself or not. Whatever is left in the kitchen, I just grab few things. I just eat. I just drink little water. I'm not sure what I had, what I didn't have. So, and she even didn't sleep properly. So that has taken toll on her health. And our ill health and paralysis attacks influence very badly about our lives also. It has turned upside down. So I don't want to scare you, but this is reality. That's why we have to take care of ourselves. Isn't it?
Yeah.
Our mom said. And she also said one more thing. Rajni, you are in the medical background. With your medical knowledge, try to help women like me so that if they gain knowledge, they will give importance to themselves. I think that day is today.
Really?
Yeah. How nice.
Yeah.
And it's been 10 years since I lost it. Okay, but still, I don't want to waste her pain. So every pain I want to use as a pearl of knowledge for everybody.
Wow.
So, are we important or not in the family?
Very.
So, busy young mothers, don't forget yourself while taking your care of your kids and all, your husband, your in-laws. You are also very important. Look at this picture. It suits you. It suits most of us.
Yes.
So, healthy woman, she will insist everybody in the family to eat healthy because she knows the value of eating healthy, right? So, healthy woman, healthy family, happy family, right? So, I just, poor nutrition. I just told my mom's example. That itself is an example of poor nutrition. Still, I would like to tell you in broad. So, WHO experts say that worldwide there are many incurable diseases like diabetes, blood pressure, heart stroke, brain stroke, kidney stroke, and cancers are prevailing more nowadays, different types of cancers. A couple of decades before, we have we know only breast cancer, but there are many other cancers that are popping up now. Scientists also accept that poor nutrition is one of the major causes of these diseases. So it has declined the quality of life of many, and also theoretically, even biologically, scientists say that human potential is 120 plus years. Can you believe this? So there is decline in decades, so many decades in the lifespan. It has come to an average of 65-70 and not. So what are the common health issues in the woman which you are all facing?
Bone pains, leg pains.
Recently started with the back pain, standing for a long time.
Standing for backache, leg pain, mood swings. At times irritation, irrespective of your age, even young age also.
Yes.
Especially before,
especially
before menstrual periods. And severe headache, any tenderness of breast. Yeah, few people face that. So these are the common health issues we generally face. Polycystic ovarian disease, polycystic ovarian syndrome. Polycystic ovarian syndrome. Syndrome is nothing but cluster of symptoms. So when you have cysts inside your ovary, you'll have cluster of symptoms like losing hair, putting on weight, lots of acne on face, lots of hair on the face, and especially obesity, obese-like feeling, overweight issues, and premenstrual syndrome. Premenstrual syndrome is associated with mood swings, headaches for most of the girls, and sometimes breast tenderness. And joint issues after certain age is very common, just like how Sarla said and how Vivika said. I should share my story only. In my early 30s, I had severe backache and radiating leg pain as well, sciatica. So when I consulted doctor, they asked me to take MRI and they have diagnosed spondylolisthesis. Isn't it scary? Spondylolisthesis stage 2, stage 1, L5 over S1, something blah blah blah. The doctor told me to get the various blood tests done, and that's because of extreme deficiency of vitamin D. Can you believe?
I am one among the doctor.
Yeah.
At the age of 35, the same thing happened to me. It's because of vitamin D deficiency. Too much of pain, back pain. I myself didn't know because I used to, I'm an athlete actually, but then
finally I came to know that it's because of vitamin D deficiency.
Yes, and that too in early 30s. So I need to restrict many of the exercises which I am doing. So single vitamin deficiency is causing physical impairment in your life.
Causing physical impairment.
Do we deserve that? Do we actually deserve it? I don't think so.
No.
Yeah. So let's talk about bone health. So why is bone health important? A bit example, just example which I shared now. So what? Why is bone health important? Can anyone speak up, please?
Bone is basically the whole structure. Our whole body is dependent on it. So if some, it's like, you know, if the structure of a building becomes weak, the building becomes weak.
Perfect.
So it's very, very important.
It's like, yes. Very good, very good. So bone health is decided by the peak bone mass, which is formed at the till the age of 30. So bone formation is at maximum till the age of 30. And the amount of bone mass you have decides the bone health in the later. These kids, we need to take care of them. Till 30, the peak bone mass, bone density increases to the maximum. Right? So thinning of bones is called osteoporosis, which mostly women experience after certain age. So prone to be getting osteoporosis or not, this peak bone mass at the age of 30 results. If your peak bone mass is too good, it will be like excess bone mass, like a bank in your own bone. So it will not get prone to fractures or brittleness or whatever in later life. So I think young ladies who are here, they have to take this issue seriously. Try to eat calcium rich foods, vitamin D, vitamin K, protein and fats in your diet properly.
Can we measure our right now currently what is our...
Yes, you can measure through DEXA scan.
DEXA scan, right? So yes. you suggest we should get it
if
tested.
If you want to. I'll tell you, I'll come to that point. See, after certain age, we should generally get the blood test done. Basic blood test done, calcium levels, cholesterol profile, hemogram, everything to rule out what are the abnormalities. But the calcium levels will always show normal between 9 to 11 for most of them because it is the body's tendency to maintain it normal. Suppose if you are not eating properly, if you are not getting calcium through food, so what does the body do? It mobilizes calcium from the bone into blood to show it normal, to maintain it normal. Because calcium is used not only for your bone health, it is useful for multiple purposes in the body. So the bone health, if you have low bone mass at the age of 30, so you are more prone to fractures even for small stress. And also diet plays a very important role on everyday basis, as I told you. To change the entire skeletal system in the body takes 10 years, but still after 30 years, bone starts remodeling. Every day it starts reformation, destruction, it happens every day. But the rate at which we gain bone declines day by day after 30. The bone formation reduces much more in our old age. So that's why bone health is very important. So what affects bone health? Next slide, please. Okay. So what affects bone health? So many factors affect bone health. All these factors have negative impact on bone. Age. That's what we need to increase our bone mass till the age of 30. We need to educate our children to have calcium-rich foods like paneer, milk, curd, on everyday basis. And lifestyle, poor lifestyle. like eating processed foods, sleeping late in the night, less intake of water. So water is a vehicle to carry all the nutrients wherever it is required, right? Through the blood, it carries all the nutrients, and the nutrients are absorbed from the blood to different parts of the body for different functions. If you take less water, what will happen? Will the nutrients be carried properly? No. And acidic food. So any food that creates acidic environment in the blood, not in the stomach, I mean to say inside the blood. So anything, any food that is high in salt, high in sugar, high in processed fats, all create acidic environment in the blood. To balance that acidic environment, to neutralize that acidic environment, the calcium is mobilized from the bone in excess to neutralize it. So the more we eat such foods, the more calcium comes away from the bone, comes from the bone into the blood. You understand?
Eating. Please tell this again.
Yes, I'll tell you. See, acidity means you generally think about the stomach, feeling of acidity inside the stomach. No, I mean to say the food which creates acidic environment, that you cannot understand, that you cannot feel that actually. But certain foods create acidic environment inside the blood. So to protect the body and reduce that increased acidic nature, the calcium from the bone mobilizes into blood to neutralize it. Thereby weakening the bones. The more you eat, more calcium comes from the bones.
It depletes from there.
Yes, exactly. Right. And obesity, overweight. So overweight carries more load on bones, leading them, causing stress, leading to fractures. Eating disorders. Extreme weight loss, following extreme weight loss techniques. I've seen many programs online, lose weight in 5 days, lose 10 kgs in 5 days, lose 15 kg in 10 days. Do you all believe in this?
No. These are fads. No.
So eating disorders, they're following extreme fasting and this weight loss courses, crash courses. So you will be devoid of nutrients.
Liquid diets.
You will be devoid of nutrients. So it's like on everyday basis, body requires nutrients. And underweight, if anybody is underweight, as per their height and age, certain weight they have to be, like suppose the BMI. It's called BMI, you call Jaspreet?
Yes, ma'am.
Can you tell about it?
BMI, ma'am, होता है कि एक person के accordingly, उसकी height और उसके weight के accordingly हम calculate करते हैं BMI index. तो वो जो है वो neutral होना चाहिए. Maybe 18.5 normal है. उससे अगर below है वो, then हम लेते हैं उसको underweight में.
हाँ.
जी जी. उससे above है तो overweight है, and then obesity में आ जाता है person.
हाँ. Above 25 it is overweight.
Basically, it's a basic metabolic rate, right?
Yes, ma'am.
It is a metabolic index, yeah. That decides the metabolic rate. Metabolism
body
of the
mass body. Index.
Yeah. Basal metabolism is BMR. Basal metabolic rate. So, if anybody is underweight, even they have weaker bones, less dense bones. So anyone underweight, try to put on, eat well. Anyone here underweight?
What do we do with overweight?
I'll cover this in next webinar.
Please, you know, people will be dying. They will be stepping over each other to attend that webinar.
Okay.
How to lose weight the right way?
Right way. Eating right. Eating right at right time. Even if you do dieting or something, anything to lose weight, you should feel energetic and happy all the time. and your face should be radiating. You should have that sparkle in your eyes. And then I can say that you are on the right path. You should look younger than your age if you are eating right. So lack of exercise. So if anyone sedentary lifestyle, just sitting on couch, watching TV, doing nothing, you are not using any muscles in our body. So weak muscles, again weak bones. So we have to strengthen the muscles through exercise. So strong muscles will have strong bones. What can you do to keep your bones healthy? Any one thing from your side?
Avoid aerated drinks.
Okay. Aerated drinks.
Calcium and yes. Vitamin D combination.
Yes, yes, yes. Avoid aerated drinks. Good point. I think I missed this before. So aerated drinks like soda, cola, whatever. Even if you admit it's sugar free or with sugar, it's okay, it doesn't matter, but it's aerated again. That's also create acidic environment inside the body. The same like before, again, the calcium comes from bone, you neutralize that. So try to avoid aerated drinks. Okay? Then, what can you do to keep your bones healthy?
Eating calcium, iron rich food.
Yes. More than iron, I should say it's calcium, the main fundamental nutrient which we require for our bone. Calcium rich foods. What are the various calcium rich foods? Jaspreet, can you tell me? She's a nutritionist.
Dairy products, ma'am. Milk, cheese, curd. और एलमंड हो गए मैम, ग्रीन लीफी वेजिटेबल्स लाइक स्पिनेच, लेट्यूस और केल,
ब्रोकली,
दिस जी जी ब्रोकली, दिस ऑल आर कैल्शियम रिच,
रोस्टेड ब्लैक चना,
जी जी
यस यस यस, ओके, सो कैल्शियम एंड आल्सो वी नीड फास्फोरस, विटामिन डी, एवरीबॉडी नोस दैट विटामिन डी एंड कैल्शियम आर रिक्वायर्ड फॉर द बोन्स अदर देन विटामिन के, प्रोटीन्स एंड फैट्स, इजंट इट? Yes or no?
One thing I wanted to understand from you, there's a lot of controversy over milk. You know, people say, you know, some people say that, you know, milk should not be because it's not meant for us, it's not meant for adults. A lot of people say, cut dairy, no dairy. And then calcium, it has to come from dairy. So there's a lot of controversy regarding milk and dairy.
My knowledge, ancient science, Ayurveda, you know, what is Ayurveda? Says you have to take cow milk every day basis. So one more thing, the latest research also says that the more milk you take, that also creates acidic environment. More tea, coffee, milk-based tea, coffee also creates acidic environment. It is not just aerated drinks. Even tea, coffee that are milk-based creates acidic environment inside the plant. So try to switch to green tea. So I prefer curd over milk. Suppose if I want to take milk, we can have a cup just before going to bed. You can add pepper and curcumin, turmeric in it, and then you can have milk. So minimize the intake of milk, but you can have the dairy in the form of cheese. You can have it in the form of paneer, in the form of curd. Curd is always better than milk because it is having good bacteria, good friendly bacteria.
Probiotic.
Yeah, exactly. So if anyone have one banana and a bowl of curd, that's the best food, I should say. Because banana is like a prebiotic. It acts as a food for the bacteria. So once you have that together, it's do wonders for your intestine. When you have lot of good bacteria in your gut, you will have the feel good senses always.
One question I have is, suppose we take a calcium tablet, or how the doctor prescribes you a calcium supplement. Now they say ki, some doctors say it's before the breakfast, some say it's after the breakfast. I really don't understand, because then this they say it hinders the absorptions of other minerals if the calcium is taken after the breakfast. So what is the correct way of taking calcium?
Yes, I have that point here. I'll come to your point. Let me cover these points and I'll get back to you that. Okay? So, build a strong foundation before the age of 30 to attain peak bone mass so that you will not have the problem of osteoporosis in later stage of life. Young women, please listen to this point very clearly. Try to have calcium-rich foods on a day-to-day basis. Alkaline water. What is alkaline water? Any water that removes acidic nature from your blood is nothing but alkaline water. How do you drink alkaline water? Anybody has started taking alkaline water?
Lemon water. Lemon. Alkaline.
Exactly.
Apple cider vinegar.
Okay.
Is an instrument also now, like I listen,
I'll tell you the cheaper way which I am doing. Shall I tell you the zero cost wala? Yes. Yes. So you can have fruits infused water. Yeah. So you can add slices of cucumber morning as soon as you get up. You can add few slices of cucumber in 1 liter of water and you can consume that water till you finish it by afternoon. So the nutrients leaches out of this cucumber into water and that creates alkaline environment once you drink. Then you can have strawberry water in this season. You can have lemon water always every time, mint water and cucumber always. Like this, of your choice, any fruit, any citrus fruits, strawberries also.
Orange slice.
Yeah, orange slice, lemon slice, anything.
If your citrus fruits.
Yeah, citrus slice, you can slice the citrus fruits. Orange comes under citrus fruit.
I take celery water also. That's...
Yes, you can take. Herbal. Yes, you can add herbs, whatever you like. Even mint.
Mint, yes.
Pudina, dhania, everything. But not methi, you may not like it.
I think dhania water is detox also, right?
Yeah, that's what detox means. It removes various free radicals. Yeah. It all comes under detox only. It removes all the harmful chemicals from your body at ease. It's easy. Instead of drinking plain water, you can enjoy the taste. Yeah, jeera is for digestion, which you have to. Yeah, you can have it early in the morning. So water lecture I'll take in my next webinar. Coming to my bone health. So again, calcium, phosphorus, vitamin D, vitamin K, proteins and fats. So most of us think only calcium and vitamin D are vital for bone health. But I say phosphorus is also equally important. Vitamin K is also equally important. Proteins and fats are also equally important. See, as per recommended dietary elements, the government, ICMR guidelines, we should have 600 mg per day. Right? It can be in the form of diet or it can form of the supplements, whatever. So, for absorption of calcium, you should have vitamin D. Without vitamin D, calcium cannot be absorbed inside the body. So, only this much everybody knows, yes, calcium supplements means calcium plus vitamin D, calcium plus vitamin D, plus this much. So, I'm going to tell you the most important thing, what the latest research has told you. So once the calcium is absorbed into the blood, either through food or in the form of supplements, if you don't have vitamin K, enough vitamin K in your blood, calcium keeps circulating in the blood circulation because it doesn't know the way where to go. We think calcium is good for bone, but I pity calcium, it doesn't know where to go. It always needs guidance. Mm-hmm. Suppose if this continues, it keeps circulating in the blood without any guidance, it starts depositing inside the blood vessels, especially arteries. This is called calcification of arteries in medical terms. So one, we don't know at what extent the calcification takes place. It may be minimum to maximum, whatever. If it starts blocking the blood vessels, it creates stress in that particular organ. It even causes immediate strokes. There are cases. Even silent heart attacks, this is one of the reasons. Even brain stroke happens. Kidney stroke also happens. Wherever it blocks the blood vessels, it causes stress in that particular area. When I read about heart attacks and the reasons behind this was one of the reasons which I understood. ladies, women who are all taking calcium supplements, please be careful. So you understood the most important point about the calcium and vitamin D? So what is the solution for this? Vinka?
Nice information, nice information.
Yeah, yeah, I didn't complete it, Vinka. This is the most hot point of the webinar, which you all should widen your ears and listen to me. So, okay, I want to switch on your cameras. That motivates me to speak. Okay, see, I told you, if the calcium keeps circulating in the body, what happens? It causes calcification of blood vessels. And the second thing, what it causes, doesn't know bichari where to go. So wherever it goes, it settles there, creates stones there, like stones in the kidneys. That is also one of the reasons for kidney stones. Excess calcium in the body. You may say, I'm taking good amount of calcium with vitamin D. Why it is excess? Why it is forming kidney stones? It has to go inside the bone. No, it will not. Vitamin K.
Okay.
If there is no vitamin K in your diet, if there is no proper amount of vitamin K, if there is no vitamin K in your supplements for bone you are taking, you must be taking calcium supplements with vitamin D only. So you must be very sure that you have to take vitamin K also along with calcium and vitamin D. So vitamin K guides calcium where required in the body. So it will guide calcium to you go into the bones, you go there, you need to do this work, that work, and everything is guided by vitamin K. Right?
Right? Yeah.
So proteins. Proteins are helpful in building up your muscles, as you all know. So if your diet is lacking proteins, your muscles will not be strong. If the muscles are not strong, again, bones will get weakened. The process of remodeling of bone on everyday basis declines. So you need to take proper protein in your diet and fats. Why fats? Fats play a vital role in repairing hormones in the body. Parathyroid hormone controls bones metabolism. That is nothing but bones metabolism is formation and destruction of bone timely. That is controlled by parathyroid hormone. If the fat intake or improper, formation of these hormones also alters. So will you take good fats hereafter? Fats. Yes, yes, you should be wise enough in selecting your fats through nuts and seeds. So whenever you have good fruits and vegetables, sprinkle some nuts and seeds. You know why I'm telling? All fruits and vegetables are rich in, again, vitamins, fat-soluble vitamins and water-soluble vitamins. So those that are fat-soluble vitamins, they need some nuts. You know watermelon? Watermelon.
Watermelon, okay.
Yes, it is red in color, so it is rich in keratins, vitamin A. How it will be absorbed inside the body without fat? So the God has arranged few seeds inside, but we always de-seed and eat it. God knows everything. He has created systems everywhere properly. So whatever you require, in that reason, He has arranged everywhere. Watermelons are available only in summer, just to quench our thirst. Why not in winters? He knows what to give. So okay, if you are eating any colored fruits and vegetables, make sure you sprinkle few nuts and seeds on it. So for better absorption of the fat-soluble vitamins. This is one of the tricks while eating fruits and vegetables. Good?
Fruits and?
Vegetables. Okay. Yeah, colored. Suppose if you are eating grated carrot, sprinkle some seeds.
Yeah.
Fill sesame seeds in it and have it. Relish it. You'll get the complete nutrition. Taking motto to take good food itself is a big thing for us. So when you take it in a proper way. Right?
So it can be just one type of seed, not that.
No. Any seeds, sunflower seeds, watermelon seeds, muskmelon seeds, sesame seeds, flax seeds.
Nothing fancy.
Nothing. Yeah. Have a big bowl of mixed seeds at home. Use just one spoon, whatever you eat in the form of raw fruits and vegetables.
How about the flax seeds, Rajni?
Flax seeds are good. I'll come to that point again. They are rich in omega 3 fatty acids. Which are very essential for the body in making, especially the brain cells. Omega-3s are very essential, which we don't get through diet mostly. Certain acids, certain fatty acids, we don't get through diet also. So we need to rely on supplements as well. And exercise. So exercise every day, 30 minutes. So many things to consider, right?
So many in one
but page. It's a must. Instead of pain, this is fine.
Yeah.
Right? No pain. Only gain. Not fat. Good eating, right? Eating good things will not make you fat. Once you understand body, what makes you, what you eat, it makes me fat. You should understand. Because every diet differs from person to person. The even postural defects, you have to be very careful while you are maintaining postures while sitting, sleeping. Of course, it's not in your control, but still, you have to be conscious, right? So your total body weight is balanced evenly when you maintain a right posture. If you don't maintain a right posture, standing long on one leg, and then imbalance weight is going to affect that particular area. It is going to affect that particular joints and bones. It will weaken those joints. And the most common zone of the skeletal system, usually we get affected as a woman, is lumbar and sacral region, which is nothing but the lower part of the spine. And even the hip, femoral bones. So be careful, take care of them. So don't ignore even a small pain in your back. So take proper treatment, do exercises, keep moving. If you keep moving, our joints will be healthy, muscles will be stable.
Thank you, Rajni.
Thank you. Any questions related to bone health? Hope you all understood.
Rajni, I have one question.
Yes, please.
I have one question. So this diet, whatever we add, nuts and all the fruits and vegetables, that's actually a very good point. Many of us have no idea. Because I see people eating loads and loads of veggies and fruits separately, but there is no absorption. That's a very valid point.
Yeah.
But one question what I have is, if you're eating flax seeds every day, meaning every day literally without changing it. Is there any difference in absorption or you need to keep changing the kind of fats what you have?
No need. You can have a mixture of seeds and nuts. Because every seeds and nuts have different types of fatty acids and everything the body requires. So whatever you eat, most of the essential fatty acids are prepared inside the body. But certain things we need to get through diet only.
Okay.
And one more thing.
So consistently you're eating something, it is okay.
Yes, of course. Body requires in minimum quantities on daily basis, which try your best to procure the same through diet. So in 1 kg jar, you can have a mix of different types of seeds like sesame, black sesame, white sesame, muskmelon, watermelon, sunflower seeds, and even chia seeds, even flax seeds. And flax seeds are also again light colored and dark brown colored flax seeds. All these you just mix and keep. Not the nuts, only seeds. Only seeds.
Roasted? No.
You can just roast it and keep just to avoid some bugs.
Acha, okay. Otherwise, it doesn't matter.
But it's always better to roast because they are available in dry form just to kill the bacteria or bugs, whatever.
Okay.
I generally do that.
No, can we grind them into a meal?
Yes, that's a very wonderful one. That's a good question. Yes, it creates a huge difference. Once you grind, the fatty acids are exposed to the external atmosphere and it may turn into rancid. It may get spoiled.
Okay.
So better always, better you chew, eat along with fruits and vegetables. And one more important thing I want to guide you all. In North India, I have seen people having salads with food. So, in North India, most of them have salads along with their diet, regular diet, lunch, breakfast or dinner.
Along with their meals, yes.
Yeah, along with their meals. So, they generally prefer mooli, tomato, keera.
Yeah. Mooli, keera and onion, maybe if mooli is available. Otherwise, onion though is... Onion, tomato, though, is staple throughout the year with lemon and
So I want all the ladies to understand one point based on research studies. Whatever I'm speaking is based on all research data, right? So make clear, be clear in what I'm going to tell you now. Never mix cooked food with uncooked food.
Mm-hmm.
My sincere advice to everybody. Okay. I'll make you understand. See, suppose if you are eating only salad. Chalo, abhi to maine bol diya seeds add karenge. Okay, if I just ask you to eat a bowl of cucumber, carrot, like you feel heavy? No. You feel light after certain, like after half an hour or 1 hour, right? It means it easily gets digested in your body, isn't it?
True.
So when you mix the same with the cooked food, body gets confused. Which one has to be digested at the earlier?
Mm-hmm.
Raw vegetable doesn't need that many acids to get digested like the cooked one.
Yeah.
So whatever you have made a delicious, nutritious, rich in proteins, good fats, whatever, finally the digestion is not proper. So what is the fun in having and eating that way when you are not getting nutrients into the body? Right. And that is going to affect your digestive system as well, causing bloating, gas formation, indigestion, constipation for you. So never mix. You can have this natural food in between meals. So when you have in between meals, like 2 hours post breakfast, or 1 hour prior, before lunch, you can enjoy this. So you can either in the form of mixed fruits or single fruit or mixed salad, whatever. So you can grab all the nutrients from there, even fiber. So it makes you full, feel full so that you will not overeat in the lunch. So then you can eat smartly. You can reduce the roti content. You can reduce the carbohydrate content, rice or whatever. Just have a bowl of this dal, whatever, some vegetables and 1 cup of curd to get proper calcium. So good fiber as well. And that's how you have to change your diet. These are my small suggestions before stepping into live life to the fullest.
Awesome.
So live life to the fullest. Yes?
Yes.
So to live life to the fullest, again, we need to balance the 4 basic pillars of health, which I told you in the beginning. So the 4 basic pillars are nutrition, physical activity, relaxation, and sleep. So nutrition. A healthy diet promotes bacteria in the gut that helps feel-good signals get through the brain. Right? Especially if your diet is rich in fiber and probiotics, you will get that feel-good signals. Sometimes for no reason, even if you are having a good diet, at times you feel you are so irritated for no reason. This is one of the reasons if there is imbalance in your gut bacteria. All the processed foods creates imbalance in the body. Imbalance in the amount of gut bacteria. How can you replace this? How can you balance this on an everyday basis? I'll tell you the best part. If you are not diabetic, have one banana and cup of curd as first thing in the morning. This is my diet. I love to eat banana every day after knowing the nutritive values.
Plus, I think it's very good for joints also. It has that.
Why you get a joint pain? Because of, again, acidic nature created in the blood. Causes joint inflammation. So joint inflammation is caused to multiple reasons. If you are overweight and stress is bearing on the joints, if you don't have enough muscle strength, if you don't have enough bone strength. So multiple reasons causes joint issues. Again, it is a very big, different topic. So you understood this point. So make sure you add curd in your diet. Make sure you have raw fruits and vegetables in between meals to add good amount of fiber. So make sure you have all the pulses. If you are non-veg, you can have fish, chicken, meat on regular basis, but use little oil. Monounsaturated rich fatty acids you should use for cooking. So make sure whenever you buy any cooking oil, read the nutritional information. Look for the contents. Monounsaturated fatty acids, polyunsaturated fatty acids, saturated fatty acids. The top, it should be monounsaturated fatty acids, less poly and saturated. That's good for health, actually.
So do we go with canola oil or do we go with...
Any oil, I want you to check the nutritional information. And make sure it do not catch smoke when you fry or cook. Because it loses its fatty acid chains, and that will be very harmful to you.
Sorry, I'll say that again. So we should look for polyunsaturated fatty acids on the...
No, we should look for high amount of monounsaturated fatty acids.
Monounsaturated fatty acids.
Yes. I will share the details in the WhatsApp group later. For example, how to select. I'll just send you the images of nutritional information of certain types of oils so that you can understand better. So when I was a kid, my mom, she used sunflower oil. And in South, mostly everybody use sunflower oil. In North, they use mustard oil. And few, they use rice bran oil. So it is not the source. I mean, everything is refined. So we have to shift in our thinking. We should not look for the type of oil. We have to look for the type of fatty acids. So forget whether it is canola, whether it is olive, anything. Just look at the nutrition information. And it should be suitable for Indian cooking.
Okay.
Could you repeat?
How about?
Nirmit, what I say, you have to look for cooking oils. Nutrition, whenever you buy cooking oils, you have to look at the nutritional information at the back of it. You make sure... You see monounsaturated fatty acids at the highest content. We have to use less polyunsaturated fatty acids and less saturated fats. So make healthy food swaps like trading white rice, pasta and bread for whole grain versions. So what are whole grain versions? So what are whole grain versions? Brown rice?
Different
types of carbohydrates.
Different types of rice combinations, I think.
So this you are all aware, but I want you to understand the science behind this. White rice, pasta, bread, maida, causes flour, suji, all these have very high glycemic index. What does it mean? So when you have these foods, the energy that is released will be very rapid in huge amounts at one time. If that is not consumed by your body, it will release high amount of insulin. So the excess energy, if you are not using immediately, that is stored as fat inside the body. Even carbs make you fat more than fats. It is not the food fat that makes you fat. High carbs intake makes you fat. That's why they say switch to brown rice, switch to millets, switch to quinoa, all these things. Yes, So you want to have only white rice but still stay healthy? I have a tip for you all. So reduce the amount of rice, increase the vegetables that you fried, and increase the dal content. If you are having one bowl of vegetables, one bowl of dal, one bowl of curd, have only one bowl of rice. Small katori. Okay.
One thing I was thinking, what about, you know, this idli, dosa, or batter, they have rice. So, is that good? We should
try. We just grate some vegetables in the idli batter and steam the idli. Make sure you just add something in the plain rice, just to decrease its glycemic index. You can have grated vegetables on top of dosa, and then you can have. You may ask me again, this is cooked and uncooked. This is not overcooked. Okay, then 5 servings of fruits and vegetables a day. It may be practically not possible. At least try to maintain 2 to 3 servings of fruits and vegetables every day. And make sure you have different colored fruits and vegetables like rainbow, the entire mix. You can try your best. And stick to only seasonal, locally available fruits for high nutritive values. Next slide. Exercise. 30 minutes of exercise. Just that it is like a request for us. At least you do 30 minutes of exercise every day. So moving your muscles produces endorphins. They are feel-good hormones, a chemical that helps the brain deal with stress. They are the feel-good hormones. You feel good as if you achieved something. So many things, which is unexplainable. Once you start doing exercise, you will feel that. So, do weight-bearing exercises like walking, aerobic exercises, cycling and jogging, and weight training. This is very important for us, for women, as we age. The decline in the muscle mass and bone mass will be at faster rate as we age. So, to strengthen our muscles, we need to do weight training exercises. It is not just walking. So, I really want to stick to this point. See, I know many in my society, among my family, friends, relatives. When I say you should have physical activity, they say, yes, I'm doing 1 hour walking, I'm doing 45 minutes walking, half an hour walking. They just give me this data. Very rarely I find women doing all sorts of exercises, going to gym and all. So how many of you are really doing only walking till today? Doing only walking. I want you all to switch on the cameras, please.
I will wind up dancing.
Okay. These are all aerobic activities, and I want women, as we approach menopause or after we enter menopause, we'll have low estrogen levels, and that declines the muscle mass and even the bone mass. If you don't do strength training exercises like small weight lifting, squats and all, the muscles will become more weaker and weaker, and we will be more prone to fractures. Make sure you strengthen your muscles. It is not just walking. You have to do many weight-bearing exercises as well as muscle strengthening exercises. It's a must for your well-being. Next slide, please. Relaxation. So, mentally unwinding can reduce stress and anxiety as well as increase energy and focus. Yes. Nirvit breathing, visualization, meditation are all effective relaxation techniques. Sound sleep helps lower stress, improve concentration and boost your emotional stamina. The next. And few more tips again. If you are 30 plus or 35 plus, make sure you have routine blood test, like which can tell you about your blood sugar levels, cholesterol levels and iron levels, which is very mandatory periodically, once in a year at least. Okay. Testing will vary for the young person and for the those who are above 35 and those who are above 40 and 50. So the repetition will be more in older ages and the repetition will be a bit lesser in younger ages. Even if you have a good amount of hemoglobin, you need to understand the iron binding capacity, which can be ruled out in various blood tests. Even that is also very important. Because if the iron binding capacity is too low, you will have low energy levels. Even vitamin B12, vitamin D levels. If you are deficient, if you have extreme low levels, you will have low energy levels, tiredness, fatigue all the day. And once the blood test, if you have any vitamin levels that are deficient, lower than lower limit. If you are deficient, you need to take the treatment dose, the dose, not the supplement dose. Keep this in mind. And the treatment dose is advised by the doctor. If all your blood tests are normal, still you maintain a normal life, even if you are eating proper good nutrition, I'm sure it is not possible to get 100% nutrients on daily basis, which are very essential for body function. So supplements will be of great help for you after a certain age. So if you are sure that you are not eating good nutritious food and all, it's always better to take supplements help even at any age. Hope ladies, all you understood basic health tips from this webinar. Please follow these health tips. Stay fit, strong, healthy and happy. Spread health and happiness everywhere. Any questions from your side? Vinka, questions from your side?
Yeah.
Nirmit, any questions from your side?
Yeah. Questions, kya? We need the whole health plan from you now.
Yes, I'm there, of course.
You know what? No, I really want to thank you because a lot of things are there as myths. You know, a lot of myths are there and there's no scientific evidence. People just listen to this person, that person and go ahead. So it's very well you have explained everything. You know, why this is not required. Everybody knows why whole grain. But then they don't know that, you know, if you don't eat whole grain, it'll go here. Now that is scary. That will, like, you know, definitely tell you. And the exercise part, even like most people think that, you know, a walk is fine, fast walking is good for losing weight and all such things, but this strength training, that is also required. It's nice.
Yeah, I tell you, those who do only constant walking, many have undergone knee replacement surgeries. You know why? Those who are obese and overweight, the entire weight is bared by the joints, especially knee joints. And they just do only walking for 1 hour using only particular type of muscles in the body. So 1 hour constantly, the entire weight is bared by knees. You are putting more pressure on your bones that way. That's why we have to do mixture of exercise irrespective of your weight.
And also, you know, people think that, you know, sitting down is good. But, you know, many doctors, they say that, you know, you should not sit down, should sit on a chair because that puts pressure on the knees.
If you're used to physical activity right from childhood till now, you can sit down. If you're not used to, don't sit there. Better don't take risk. Tune your body very well through activities, physical activities, then you can sit. You can do yoga, Pilates. Especially strength training exercises is very crucial for women above 40. Sarla?
So first is, your health is your priority.
Yes.
And if you are good to go with your health. So you will spread, first of all, you will, like, you know, introduce healthy habits to your children. And secondly, if you are happy with your health, you will spread happy vibes in your family. If you are irritated, stressed, so that is what will show.
Yeah, true.
You are what you eat, again.
Perfect. Perfect. Well said, Ram. So, Sarla, can you speak out?
Yeah, Rajni, actually, this is like very informative. Even being a practitioner and learning about nutrition from pretty many days, this is such a news for me. You have added so many things which I haven't noticed. That minor addition of certain things to regular food, what we eat, is bringing huge change. This is really helpful for many of us. Thank you for this good initiative.
So nice. Thank you so much. I think this single dose, as you said, single dose of knowledge on health and nutrition, I'm sure the way you look at food now will definitely change. Your perception will definitely change. So whatever you...
Seeds on fruits and vegetables, like, this was amazing.
Yes.
Really, really nice. It makes a lot of sense that, you know, naturally it is present. And we all know that, you know, the way things are there in nature, if you consume it that way, it's good, but yes. Never thought of it like, you know, putting seeds. Pumpkin yes. seeds separately kha lete hain, you know, bazaar se laake field wala. But then in that we don't take watermelon seeds. Sab bahar se aate hain. But then you have to sprinkle it on food. That was something very very amazing.
Yes, you can even have nuts in between meals. Suppose if you are traveling, Nirmit, you often travel, so you carry fist like you carry mixed nuts. Along with seeds, you just mix everything in one small box and carry with you always in your hand, right? So that whenever you travel, you need not pick unhealthy food. You can have a fistful of nuts and kill your hunger. It is not killing hunger. It will maintain your appetite long. That's the best way while traveling. I applied all these when I was traveling long. And that has helped me a lot. So look,
I also want to add that so generally in my lifetime, I'm very worried about consuming oil because my father and my mother, they both have heart issues. Like they have history of heart conditions. So oil is very, it's like a concern for me, how much oil I should, you know, consume and how much I shouldn't. That entire MUFA,
monounsaturated
fatty acids is quite helpful.
Yes, yes.
So now, whenever we buy our oil, we're going to check the, you know, the label at the back and buy the ones which is high in MUFA, because that's going to also take away, you know, the worry that how much oil are we consuming and how much we should and all that.
Because that will not deposit inside your blood vessels.
Yes, exactly. Which would be quite helpful.
Yes.
Without taking away the taste of the food.
Yes, definitely. Okay. Thanks to everyone for your valuable time and listening to me. So So next webinar, I will decide the topic, or you can pour your inputs and your requests, whatever, like the type of topics you want to listen to in my next webinar. And also I'll improve myself in my next webinar, as this being the first webinar for me. Thank you so much. Happy Women's Day to you all super women.
Thank you, Rajni. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you, Rajni. It was very, very highly informative and very well explained.
Explained.
Thank you so much. I tried my best. Thank you.